what's going on, guys? Session workout today, named Y'all Are So Extra. The workout is 4x, 10 bar muscle ups, 20 lateral box jump overs, 24 20-inches, 30 deadlifts, 255 for guys, 170 for ladies, 20 lateral box jump overs, and then 10 bar muscle ups. So this one's gonna get us prepped a little bit for a quarterfinal workout that's a little bit shorter. Might not see something like this in the open, but for those of you that are qualifying for quarterfinals, you'll probably see something like this. A good test for your Saturdays in preparation for quarterfinals. So we have Sydney and Nate here demoing this one for us. We'll get into their strategies here and then we'll watch them hit this workout.
So workouts, 10 bar muscle ups, 20 lateral box jump overs, 30 deadlifts. I got 255. And then back down, do the 20 lateral and then the 10 bar muscle ups. I'm feeling 4-3-3 bar muscle up. The lateral box jumps the first way through, should be able just to cycle through them. And then deadlifts probably going 5 sets of 6. And on my way back, I think my hips are gonna be a little shot from the deadlifts going back to the lateral. So I'm gonna do those a little bit slower than my first one. And then my my strategy for the 10 bar muscle ups at the end is don't let go.
All right, my strategy today is on the first set of bar muscle-ups, 2 sets of 5. And then on the first set of box jumps, I'm really going to try and be keeping my breath down. I think the box jumps in this workout is a hurdle that you're either going to push through or it's going to knock you down. So on the first set, it's really going to be focusing on my breathing, one big set of 20. And then on the deadlifts, I'm probably just going to go singles at 170. And then on my way back down to the box jumps on the second set, I'll probably break it up into 2 sets of 10. I don't know how my legs are going to be feeling on the deadlifts. I know they're going to be pretty shocked, so I don't want to eat the box. And then on the last set of bar muscle-ups, I'm going to hang on to the bar for as long as I can, try and knock all 10 out without coming down.
So this one was a sneak attack, as you called it?
Yeah, Sid? Sneak attack.
Yeah.
The heart rate shot up real quick.
Is this the false start? Are we watching the false start right now? No?
No.
Oh, okay. Did you delete that? Okay.
Oh. Oh,
I was like, there's no way that was false. There was a false start.
There was a Nate false started.
And nobody was gonna catch you.
We saw it.
So on this set, the first set, I knew that I needed to break it up, even if I wanted to just get them over with. It would not be a smart idea to knock out that big set.
Why?
10 at first. Just fatigue, forearm fatigue, and I already knew my heart rate was going to be high on those box jumps, so I didn't want to go into it with a super high heart rate.
Yeah. What was your shit? What were you?
See, I went into it knowing like I wasn't going to get the 5 and 5. Like I knew I could get 5 in a row, but it was that second set of 5. I didn't think I'd be able to repeat.
Yeah.
So I went 4-3-3, and I felt pretty good on that. Like knowing going into the box jumps, I could go through that pretty quick.
Yeah.
I mean, looks like I'm going a little bit faster than Sid here.
No, yeah. Your bounding on these is definitely quicker.
You aren't extending as fully as I am.
Yeah. Okay. That and your bounding. Like, I think, Sid, you're like step, almost like flat foot and then re-jumping. So that might just be something you could learn to work, or learn to do later on. Single city.
Yes.
Yeah, we figured out this was like a 60% of our one rep weight for each of us. So,
okay.
I don't think either of us actually has a one rep max deadlift.
No, Nate just did it. Was that a 2? Oh, that was a 3 RM, right?
Yeah.
That was also after a mile run, so that doesn't count.
Yeah, we did a workout a few weeks ago where it was a heavy
after
deadlift.
A warm up, okay. Oh yeah, both of you guys did that. Yeah, it was a warm up.
Yeah. Now, you can tell I ripped off my belt super quick. I think it was like into rep 6 or something. It was digging into my stomach and I couldn't breathe. So I was just like, my back is gonna have to blow up. And because I knew my heart rate and breathing was more important than my back blowing up on this.
Yeah, 100%. That's why I fucking hate wearing belts.
Yeah.
I really enjoy breathing. And I don't really care so much about my back.
Nice. You might care when you're a little older, but.
Yeah, we'll touch base on that 20-year-old.
That's a problem for future Kyle.
Gonna roll my back spread.
Yeah. Okay, so Nate, you wanted to go touch and go then, right?
Yeah, I figured 6 sets of 5, or I might have said 5 sets of 6 before, but after that first round of 5, I felt like that was a good pace to keep up. And
yeah,
I mean, I could, if I remember correctly, like Sid only finished like 5 seconds before I did, and then we caught back up at the end of the box jump overs.
Yeah. No, I think that was, your rests are pretty short between your sets. Like, you're able to already come back on. So that was like, I think that was a perfect strategy for sets of five. You started to slow down around 23,
yeah,
right?
Around 20, 22, 23. It wasn't even fatigue in my muscles or my grip. Mm-hmm. It was all heart rate and breathing.
That's what slowed you down?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's what slowed me down on this. The first couple of reps, I was a little sketchy because I did not want to eat the box. That wouldn't be cute. But And then right there, I was just like, oh, I need to get this done.
Yeah, the first five or six box jumps after the deadlifts were pretty hard. I felt my legs being heavy.
Yeah.
So I knowingly, in a past workouts structured like this, ooh, I have eaten the box.
That was so close. That would have been
fun. No, I tried doing what you do, where you put your foot on the edge
and slide off.
And I realized it was like too hard for the level of fatigue my legs were at. So I was like, I'm not going to do that one.
Well, on bounding, I don't really do that either. For future reference, I'll just jump off the top like you're doing.
So like we finished.
Yeah, same time. Caught me on that. But I knew I was going to get him on these bar muscle ups, so I wasn't even worried about it.
I think we all knew that.
So I was going to do sets, two sets of three, and rest at the top in between those sets instead of coming down.
Do you think you could have pushed that a little bit more? No.
I don't think so.
That was it?
Yeah.
Do you do all those on bro?
I didn't come down. But I did three, three. And
but it was like, yeah, like, it was like a pause at the top.
Yeah.
What were you thinking when you got to these? Were you like...
I was going to try to go the 4-3-3 again after... Well, prior to the workout when I said it, I said I'm just going to essentially grip it and rip it.
Mm.
But after the box jumps, I was like, there's no way I can get five.
Mm.
So I was like, all right, let's try the 4-3-3. And then after I did two of them, I was like, this is going to be tough. So I, in my head, I'm thinking I'm going to go five set to two. And I was able to do that, I think, through six. And then my seventh and eighth one, I got the seventh and the eighth one, I failed. I think that was just it.
Yeah.
And then the last three took me a minute 15. Just couldn't get it. I think I got into my head on that. Like you see my arm just...
Yep. That one, I mean, that one you just slip. Like the other one, you're obviously pushing the capacity on. So
yeah,
like you're gonna, if you're doing that, you're probably gonna miss a rep at some point. Especially because you're just not super proficient at those yet. You still have to chicken wing to get over.
No, it's interesting because
I do dig that though.
In past bar muscle up workouts like this, like I'm always, because I'm right-handed, I'm right dominant with my chicken wing. But on this, I'm going all left, so it means my left arm's getting more activated, and then I just need to kind of
even them out.
Find the happy medium in it. So, as bad as they look, I feel good about it.
They are. I mean, they are better.
It's progress for Nate. Progress.
I mean, what? 3 weeks ago, you were barely getting them, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least not in this capacity.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the fact that you guys came off the bar so close together on the first round shows that you have a huge improvement on them there. So, sick. What would you guys do differently?
I would go a little bit more aggressive on the box jumps.
Yeah.
I was super scared of them.
I feel like my strategy was pretty good on that. On that, the second set of bar muscle-ups, I should have just known that I was going to struggle and not be able to do the 4-3-3. Should have just went in knowing it was going to be five sets of two.
Yeah.
I think I would have approached it slightly differently. I don't think my time would have been drastically different.
Yeah.
Maybe shave 15 seconds off.
Yeah.
Like kind of structured how I did the deadlifts, where I took like a knowingly, or knowingly took a 5 second break.
Yeah.
Like, and then went back to it. If I just did that with the bar muscle ups, I feel like I could have probably shaved 15 seconds off.
Yeah.
But nothing too wild.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I wouldn't have changed much in this workout except for the box jumps, but future Sydney will be better at cycling the barbell.
Hell yeah. Yep. Facts. Well, good luck on this one, guys. Definitely a sprint workout. We want you guys to be somewhere around, 5-6 minutes on this one. If you guys are looking to move on from quarterfinals, you should probably be somewhere around the 4-minute mark on this workout. So nice and short, pretty quick, really gets the heart rate up. Might get some grip fatigue in there as well. But just get after it, come out hot, and just try and hold on. So looking forward to hearing how you guys do.